Welcome to Logos Bible Software. In this video, I'll walk you through a basic Bible study with Logos, focusing on three important tools: the selection menu, layouts, and the context menu. If you understand these three tools, you'll be well on your way to getting the most out of Logos. Along the way, I'll show you how to use multiple resources together, customize Logos to fit your preferences, and give you a step-by-step path to continue growing in your study with Logos. Let's get started. Let's say you're studying Mark 4, where Jesus calms the storm on the Sea of Galilee. Start by typing Mark 4:35 in the Go box. The Go box offers quick access to guides, layouts, and resources. Select Go to Mark 4:35 in your preferred Bible. Resources and Logos open in panels. To arrange your screen, click and hold a Panels tab to drag and drop it. If you prefer a different Bible, click the Parallel Resources icon. All available Bibles in your library show. Your preferred Bible shows at the top of the list. To change it, type Set Preferred Bible To, followed by the version's abbreviation in the Go box. The first tool I'd like to show you is called the Selection Menu. Click and drag text in any resource to display it. You can mark up the text with highlights, open a study or search, or create a note from this menu. Notes created from the selection menu are anchored to the text, meaning that the note links back to the resource, and the resource now shows a note icon pointing you to your note. As you study, it's important that Logos fits your preferences, so before you continue learning Logos, take a moment to customize the program to fit your needs. Click the panel menu icon and select Program Settings. Let me point out a few settings you may want to customize. First, you can choose to display Logos in light or dark mode, or to follow your computer's system settings. Second, when you open Logos, it opens the home page by default. The home page shows helpful videos and articles explaining how to use Logos along with your active reading plans and much more. But you can change this default behavior, like always showing your most recent layout whenever you open Logos for more continuity between study sessions. Next, scroll down to the accessibility settings to adjust content and program scaling. Changing these scaling options globally increases or decreases the size of text and icons all throughout the program. Last, scroll down to the text display settings. Here you can set default fonts, choose whether or not to show red letters and Bibles, change the default notes text size, and more. Logos automatically syncs your settings and any changes you make save by default. Close the settings window to return to your study. The second tool I'd like to show you is called Layouts. Layouts are collections of panels organized for study. So far, you've opened a Bible and the Notes tool. Let's add another resource, a study Bible. All your resources live in the library. You can search, sort, and filter to find any resource. If your filters don't show automatically, click the menu icon to show them. Expand Type, click More to view all options, and choose Study Bible. The Faith Life Study Bible is part of every Logos package and draws on a wide range of academic research that will help you gain a deeper understanding of the text. Click to open it, or click and drag to place it in your custom layout. I'll place mine above my notes so all three panels are visible. Logos opens the Faith Life Study Bible to Mark 4, but you can go one step further by linking your Bible and the Study Bible to scroll together. Open the panel menu for each resource, and set both panels to Link Set A. Link sets connect two or more resources so that they stay in sync. Now, when you scroll or navigate to a new passage in either panel, the other will follow. As you've opened notes and resources, you've created your own custom layout. Logos makes it easy to save these layouts so you can quickly jump back into any study. Click the Layouts tool in the upper right. At the top of the Layouts panel, your current active layout shows in miniature. Click Save as Named Layout to save this arrangement of panels. In addition to holding your custom layouts, the Layouts tool also shows quick start layouts for a variety of study types. Choose Passage Study. Notice how the Bible and commentary are already linked together in this default layout. You can close panels individually, or quickly close all panels together. Click the Layouts tool one more time and select your saved custom layout. The third and final tool is called the Context Menu. You can show it in any resource by right-clicking. It's the quickest way to access docs, guides, and tools during your study. Using the Context Menu is a two-step process. On the left side of the menu, choose an element to study. Your options are context-aware, so each resource and selection will show a different set of options. In this instance, you can choose your selection, the English word care, the verse, Mark 4:38, original language options like the manuscript, lemma, root, morph of the word, and more, or event, speaker, or theme-based elements present in this verse. As you change the element you want to study, Locus presents study options on the right that are customized to your selection. This means you don't need to figure out where all your tools live in Logos. If you can right-click, you can study anything with your tools. I'll select the lemma or dictionary form of the word care as my element to study. The right side of the menu now shows tools for studying the original Greek term. The best resource for learning more about a specific original language term is the Bible Word Study. If you don't like where Logos opens a panel, you can click and drag the panel tab to rearrange it. The Bible Word Study shows how the original word is translated in your favorite Bible, or any other Bible you choose in the settings, and offers details about the root and sense of the word in different contexts. Here, we see that the disciples are accusing Jesus of not caring like a shepherd, of being like a hired hand who cares nothing for the sheep. Let's return to the text and add a note from the selection menu mentioning this sense we discovered. To read more about this scene, take a moment to open a commentary. Return to the library and filter by Bible commentary. Then, search for Mark to narrow the results. I'm using the silver base package in Logos, so you may have more or fewer options depending on the resources you own. I'll drag Alan Cole's commentary out to my layout and set the panel to link set A so that it stays in sync with both my Bible and study Bible. Just like with your Bible, you can select text and commentaries and highlight or take a note from the selection menu. You also have access to the context menu in non-Bible resources. Logos is smart enough to understand which passage, events, and themes are discussed in the referenced passage. This means you can quickly open an atlas or a full passage guide on this text. You can see why the context menu is so powerful. It connects you to all your tools and resources from right within your study. As with the Bible, you can click the Parallel Resources button in the commentary panel to quickly switch to another commentary on Mark. Let's update our saved layout to reflect these changes for the next time we study. Finally, return to the Bible one more time so I can point out three other features to explore as you become more familiar with Logos. The inline search makes it easy to run a search in your Bible or any other resource, like where else the Gospels reference the Sea of Galilee, even if the term Galilee isn't present. The second tool is called Visual Filters. It helps mark up your text in line to show things like corresponding words, speakers, media from your library, and more. Finally, the Factbook is the best way to study themes, people, places, or events. You can visually mark Factbook entries in your text by selecting the Factbook icon. Your text will underline Factbook entries in blue. Hovering over these words or phrases shows a preview of the entry while clicking opens the full resource. As you can see, Logos is full of features and tools, but a quality Bible study doesn't require you to learn them all on your first day. If you can open or create a layout for Bible study, use the selection menu, and right-click to show the context menu, you can get the most out of Logos on day one. Now, what if you want to go a bit deeper? Let me leave you with two great ways to deepen your understanding of Logos. First, every base package includes step-by-step workflows to teach you Logos through Bible study. Click the Guides menu and scroll down to the Workflows section. I'll choose the Basic Bible Study workflow. When you add a passage, it will build out a custom study surfacing important tools and resources during your study, so you can focus in your study while learning Logos on the side. You'll learn things like more advanced highlighting styles, how to compare Bible versions, how to study key people in your passage, and more. The second tool is our Online Support Center. You can reach it from the panel menu. We've created hundreds of articles and videos like this one to answer any questions you might have about logos. Type a question about any feature in logos and we'll help you get started. If you enjoy learning by watching videos, I'd encourage you to start with the Basic Bible Study series. Here you'll learn the core skills to do Bible study in logos while you study the Bible together with a facilitator. Welcome to Logos Bible Software. We can't wait to see how God uses it to help you grow in the light of the Bible.